This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book Castes in India by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. Castes in India. I need hardly remind you of the complexity of the subject I intend to handle. Subtler minds and abler pens than mine have been brought to the task of unraveling the mysteries of castes, but unfortunately it still remains in the domain of the unexplained. Not to say of the ununderstood, I am quite alive to the complex intricacies of a hoary institution like caste, but I am not so pessimistic as to relegate it to the region of the unknowable, for I believe it can be unknown. The caste problem is a vast one, both theoretically and practically. Practically, it is an institution that portends tremendous consequences. It is a local problem, but OJIE capable of much wider mischief. For as long as caste in India does exist, Hindus will hardly intermarry or have any social intercourse with outsiders. And if Hindus world migrate to other regions on earth, Indian caste would become a world problem. Theoretically, it has defied a great many scholars who have taken upon themselves, as a labor of love, to dig into its origin. Such being the case, I cannot treat the problem in its entirety. Time-space ad acumen, I am afraid, would fail me if I attempt to do otherwise than limit myself to phase of it, namely the genesis, mechanism and spread of the caste system. I will strictly observe this rule, and will dwell on extraneous matters only when it is necessary to clarify or support a point in my thesis. To proceed with the subject. According to well-known ethnologists, the population of India is a mixture of Aryans, Dravidians, Mongolians and Scythians. All these stocks of people came into India from various directions and with various cultures, centuries ago, when they were in a tribal state. They all in turn elbowed their entry into the country by fighting with their predecessors, and after a stomachful of it settled down as peaceful neighbors. Through constant contact and mutual intercourse they evolved a common culture that superseded their distinctive cultures. JK may be granted that there has not been a thorough amalgamation of the various stocks that make up the people of India. And to a traveller from within the boundaries of India, the East presents a marked contrast in physique and even in colour to the West, as does the South to the North. But amalgamation can never be the sole criterion of homogeneity, as predicated of any people. Ethnically, all peoples are heterogeneous. It is the unity of culture that is the basis of homogeneity. Taking this for granted, I venture to say that there is no country that can rival the Indian peninsula with respect to the unity of its culture. It has not only a geographic unity, but it has over and above all a deeper and a much more fundamental unity, THC, indubitable cultural unity, that covers the land from end to end. But it is because of this homogeneity that caste becomes a problem so difficult to be explained. If IHC, Hindu society, were a mere federation of mutually excluded units, the matter would be simple enough. But caste is a parceling of an already homogeneous unit, and the explanation of the genesis of caste is the explanation of this praise of parceling. Before launching into our field of inquiry, it is better to advise ourselves regarding the nature of a caste. I will therefore draw upon a few of the best students of caste for their definition of it. 1. Mr. Siart, a French authority, defines a caste as a close corporation, in theory at any rate rigorously hereditary, equipped with a certain traditional and independent organization, including a chief and a council, meeting on occasion in assemblies of more or less plenary authority, and joining together at certain festivals, bound together by common occupations, which relate more particularly to marriage, and to food and to questions of ceremonial pollution, and ruling its members by the exercise of jurisdiction, the extent of which varies, but which succeeds in making the authority of the community more felt by the sanction of certain penalties, and above all, by final irrevocable exclusion from the group. 2. Mr. Nesfield defines a caste as a class of the community which disowns any connection with any other class and can neither intermarry, nor eat nor drink with any but persons of their own community. 3. According to Sir H. Risley, a caste may be defined as a collection of families or groups of families bearing a common name, which usually denotes or is associated with specific occupation, claiming common descent from a mythical ancestor, human or divine, professing to follow the same professional callings, and are regarded by those who are competent to give an opinion as forming a single homogeneous community. 4. Dr. Kedkar defines caste as a social group having two characteristics. I. Membership is confined to those who are born of members and includes all persons so born. E. The members are forbidden by an inexorable social law to marry out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.